can actually hear the slight little nudge nudge. I am giving each key a little slight push, but after I'm done with everything, I'll probably just give them all another click down. And for any reason you're cringing that I'm pulling the keys out manually like that, well, let me know why. Let me know why it's not a good idea to do that, and hopefully these keys won't break. But if they ever do and I need to get more replacements, I'll definitely keep that in mind. I do have that removal tool, I just don't know where I put it. What am I gonna do with these keys? Maybe it would actually be a better idea to take them all out and then put them all in. Gotta be careful with the bigger keys. I haven't anticipated that, but there we go. So how effective is the key removal tool with these larger keys? Starting with the tab. a little easier if you have a little nail to just slide underneath the key itself and literally separate it, almost like two Lego bricks. The keys that were replaced before seems like they were a little stronger. This key felt like it was on the verge of breaking. If any of these keys are already a little weakened, I'll definitely probably see them break now. And the enter key. Shift key felt me a little bit. Space key I'm going to keep. Bigger keys are a little more difficult to position. Some time back, I had a coworker of mine who accidentally dropped a DOS keyboard on the floor, and two keys came out. Putting them back in was easy, so he did. He just put them in the wrong place. So that was a interest and reaction of the owner to see. I don't know where your shift is now your caps lock, and your caps lock is now your shift. That slight hum you hear is just my little mini refrigerator I have. You may have not noticed in some of my other videos. Give a nice little stock of Snapple, Pepsi, bottles of water, and on the bottom, a larger area. Of course, some alcoholic based beverages. Currently right now it's empty, and don't let it give you the idea that I drank everything. I just haven't bought much lately. Getting there on this row, and probably the most popular key. Now, you might tell some of these keys are sticking out a little bit, and that's okay. As I said, I'm gonna go over each key as soon as I'm done with all this here. Randomly, some of these keys just give me that little satisfying sound that you know the key's in position. And sometimes they don't. But if you've ever removed these keys before and then you put them back, you definitely feel a little satisfaction knowing that you actually pressured it back in. The other shift key. I'm kind of wondering if these shift keys are interchangeable, and they're not, because this one is longer. If you were worried about possibly having the key in the wrong position and you're worried about pushing it down, may break it, well, you can always move it around a little bit like this, just ever so slightly, not a lot. You don't want to basically break another one. But if you move it around, then clearly it just shifts over completely and it's not in position. If it doesn't shift over hardly at all, you're probably aligned and you can give it its little nudge in. Sometimes I wish this Windows logo would remain the same, because you would see one in one keyboard that looks nice, and then they change it. There was definitely a moment I thought I broke the keycap. Nope. Got a good look. All the keys. Slightly different sound. goes my fridge. Being quieter again. As I'm over, that's decently well over halfway done with this. I do recommend you do use your thumbs to do this, not these fingers, because these fingers sometimes may tend to, it's almost like standing on one leg when you're doing the kick, and it might be the leg that you're not fond on standing on when you're doing the kick, or just standing on one leg in general. I'm debating whether or not to. I will keep these keys, obviously, just in case these break, but fortunately I haven't had a problem with these arrow keys. Okay, you can definitely tell I was putting that key in there wrong, because when I moved it, it literally shifted over quite a bit. Now I got you. Sorry if my hand is blocking the key and the camera keeps refocusing. Number 9 was fighting me there for a moment. So was number 5. On this keyboard, which by luck will probably be the most difficult. Not so bad, just have to give it a little patience. I guess with these keys you just have to work on one side just a little bit, then another, then another. Completely up to you whether you want to work from the bottom keys going up or the top keys going down. My mind's telling me, and also my fingers are telling me, probably better to go down, but that's just me. You can hear those noises, huh? Don't be afraid to hesitate. For a moment, if one key just spooks you out for a moment, just stop, reposition your fingers with the key, and then try again. For a moment there, I got a little lost with the one, and you can definitely see I took a moment and poof, now it's back in. Here we go. All the keys, with the exception of the spacebar, have been changed. Give each key a quick push. Oh, you can definitely tell some of them need a little bit more finesse. You'd rather that not happen when you're writing an important email, love letter, or even playing a video game. So all the keys are good. Here are the other ones. Thanks for watching.